I grew up young, 50s, 60s. I mean, a computer was just a big, huge mainframe that you never knew where they were. You'd never get close to it. You couldn't discover digital. You could go to a scientific bookstore like Kepler's in Palo Alto. No books on what computers were or any of that. I found a journal in a hall closet. My dad was an engineer working for Lockheed, you know, the space race going on and all. And it talked about ones and zeros and how they get added and little logic elements called gates. And I learned to draw them on paper. And I said, this is going to be my passion for life. It's like I had discovered crossword puzzles and said, that's going to be my passion. And yet nobody did it with me. There were no computers in schools, no classes in schools, no teachers, no friends. Nobody knew this stuff. I just loved it on my own, all quietly. I was very shy, so I worked quietly in my bedroom. And I started trying to design computers. How would you design them? No idea how. Just had to work it out. It took months. Didn't have any books that led me to how it's done. And I knew I'd be an engineer, but I didn't think engineers designed computers. I thought computers came out of strange places, you know, just from little things a kid reads. They come out of places like research, or they come out of places like the military. I don't know. I didn't think I'd ever design computers like as a job, even though I knew how to do it. That was, you know, so totally passion driven. A lot of things in my life were passion driven.